Hello and welcome to this session on SoapUI Beginner tutorial. Today we are going to learn about assertions and we will see what are assertions, why do we add assertions and what are the different types of assertions in SoapUI. So let's get started and let me open my SoapUI. So the SoapUI is up and running. I will just close this startup page and before we start into the practicals, let us see what exactly are assertions in SoapUI or assertions in general. So assertions are the validations on response. So whatever validations we do on the response, this is called as assertions, and we can also say assertion is expected versus actual. So what we are doing essentially is we are doing some validations on the response. It can be on the schema of the response or it can be on some values, and we are checking that what we expected and what is actual is equal or not. So that is what assertion is in a very simple way. And just to give you an example, let me go back to my SoapUI, and here I have a project where I have added two requests here. One is a SOAP request and other one is a REST request, and these projects, REST project 1 and country info service, is something that we have created in the earlier sessions. And just in case you do not know and have not seen the earlier sessions, this is the URL from where we have taken the REST request. I will add it in the notes as well. For REST I am using this example, and for SOAP we are using this particular whistle. So this is already explained in the initial sessions of this series. Okay, let me go back to my SoapUI. And yes, so here if I go to any request, so this is a SOAP request where we give the country code. For example, IN is the country code for India, and when I run this request, it will send back a response with the currency of that country. So if I run this, it is giving me a response with the currency code and the currency name. So here if you see, even after running the response, this particular icon for the request is still in gray color, and we do not know whether it is pass or fail. And SoapUI will not consider this as pass or fail because we have not added any assertions. So if you go down, you can see here we have assertions. We can click here and you can see it shows zero. That means we do not have any assertions. And here is a plus button and we can add assertions by clicking on this button. So if I say add assertion, we have so many assertions here. So let me first just give a very simple example. I will select the assertion contains and I will say add, and here I am saying INR. So I am saying that I am expecting INR to be in the response of this request. So whenever I run the request, whenever I receive a response, it should contain INR, otherwise it should be a failure, and I say okay. And now you can see the icon has changed to green, that means it passed. And similarly here as well, you can see the assertion passed. Just in case it fails, for example I give something else and say okay, you can see it failed and we can see the red color icon here. Okay, so that is what assertions is. And unless we have assertions in our requests or in our test cases, it will not be considered as pass or fail. So assertions are very important. And so that is why we use assertions. So we use assertions to signify whether a step or a test case or a request has passed or failed, and whether we are getting the response as per our expectations or not. Now coming to different types of assertions, if you go to assertions again, you can see here we have different types of assertion. For example, on the property content, we have assertions like contains, not contains. In case of XML response, we have XPath match, XQuery match. And similarly, if I go to the REST request and I run this and I go to assertion and say add, here if I go to property content, I get contains and then I get assertions based on JSON response. So we have JSON path count, JSON path existence match, a JSON path match and all these assertions, and we will look into it into more details in the next session. So these are different assertions. Also, if you see here, we have some compliance assertions. So here these compliance status and standards assertions validates our response against some standards. And then we can have script assertions, we can add script, we can have SLA assertions for the response times, we can have security assertions, and so on. So in the next episode, we are going to learn about these assertions in details. I hope this session was useful for you. I will meet you in the next episode, where we will look more deeply into assertions. Thanks for watching.